Hello, I'm Margaret Martin at Milio Guide, registered physiotherapist, here to discuss with you flexion and extension of our vertebral column, also another word for our spine. So let's look first at flexion and extension of the vertebral column relative to the whole body. So if I start to flex my body, I'm flexing all of my joints from the toes, knees, hips, my spine is flexed, my elbows, my wrists and my fingers are all in flexion. So everything's coming forward in the sagittal plane, and now I am going into extension. So now we get to specifically look at flexion and extension in different planes of movement for our spine. So as you notice, as it came into flexion of the lumbar spine, that means I'm bending forward, my spine is flattening. Now if I want to go into flexion of the thoracic spine, I start to bring my shoulders forward. If I want flexion of the cervical spine, that's where I bring my neck forward. It's not a movement I do very often, so I'm a bit stiff coming down, but that is flexion of the spine. Now I'm going to come out of this. I'm going to come out first through the lumbar spine. I'm going to get a little arch there. I'm going to now start to extend more through the thoracic spine or mid back, and now I'm extending through the cervical spine. If I continue back, I made an end on my head, so I'm not going to keep going, but that's extension in its fullest in the spine. So if we look at that in sitting, the surface that we're sitting on largely will influence whether we're in flexion or extension. With my knees a little lower than my hips, it allows me to tilt my pelvis forward and encourages more extension through the spine. So this is bringing me into a little more extension in my lumbar spine. I can exaggerate that extension through my thoracic spine. And if I was looking up at something in the ceiling, I would be also extending my cervical spine. Too often, people spend a lot of time in flexion. So flexion is now where all the vertebrae start to lean forward, and I'm in flexion in my entire spine. If I wanted to continue all the way down into flexion, you would be reaching all the way to the floor. It's important for people to realize that we have flexion and extension in every movement that we do, and that you're in control of that movement. So let's explore it as we go down to the ground, because a lot of people choose to sit on the floor. And if we're sitting on our heels, that's a great way to, again, get the knees a little lower than the hips, so that's tilting the pelvis ever so slightly, encouraging that extension in the lumbar spine. That little bit of extension in the lumbar spine is a really healthy thing to help the thoracic spine be in its best alignment. So now we're talking neutral here. But if I wanted to, you know, go all the way back, I would now be going into extension of my spine. Or if I wanted to go forward, and you'll see this done in yoga poses, now I'm going into flexion. Certain sitting postures, as you might see people sit cross-legged. Now, when we sit like this, that will naturally tilt the pelvis in the opposite direction and encourage more flexion. So this flexion in both the lumbar, you see I've lost that little arch, and now it's encouraging more flexion through my thoracic spine and flexion through my cervical spine. We can take this down one more step, which is down to the floor. When we sleep in a fetal position, we are in flexion of the lumbar spine, the thoracic spine, and the cervical spine. Now, you could encourage a little more extension or neutral position of your body when you're sleeping by bringing your head back and maybe aligning your shoulder relative to your hip. So that would encourage more neutral positioning. For people that like to sleep on their stomach, not always great for your neck, but it does encourage extension through the spine. Now, if you'd like to sleep with a pillow underneath the front of your body, then you're going into extension. If you're doing any yoga poses, whether it's Sphinx or whether it's Cobra, these movements are bringing you into extension of your spine. For individuals who like to sleep with pillows tucked underneath their chest or their head and neck, then realize that you're putting your back in quite a bit of extension. Not that it's a lot, but it's for a long time. So your facet joints might not always appreciate it, but this is one way that you can certainly get into extension. Now, if you do a simple yoga pose, even just hanging out on your wrist or your forearms, or if you come up to a cobra, all of these are going into extension of your spine. So recognize that in life, we do a lot of flexion and extension of our spine, but we just tend to do a lot more flexion. So when it comes to extension and flexion of the spine, there's another component that I think is really important for people to understand, and that's the difference between passive movement and active movement. So passive flexion, I'm just letting gravity sink me down. This is passive flexion. And like an active flexion would be a sit-up. If I'm looking at passive extension, if I just prop myself here, my back is in extension, but it's passively there. My back doesn't have to do anything. My shoulders and arms are supporting the position. So that makes it passive for my spine or the spinal muscles. Whereas if I go down and then lift myself up with my spinal muscles, this is active extension of the spine. And this is also very important to understand when looking for ways to keep our spine safe. We need both the passive, but even more important, we need the active extension. That's what's making all the muscles work around the spine so that holding a neutral position feels a lot more comfortable. What I found with my clients is that they are so used to being in flexion that if I encourage them to go into extension, they're just getting to neutral and they think they're in extension. They already feel like, oh, I'm so open. I feel so different than I usually do. So this is where it becomes important that people spend a bit of time every day on their stomach. You know, at the very least, with elbows under chin, and then going into a bit of a spinal stretch, or what we call a cobra, so that you have some point of reference to what is the opposite spectrum to flexion. Since we spend so much time, 95% or more of our day in flexion, but hardly any time in extension. But we need to spend time in extension so that neutral feels comfortable. If neutral doesn't feel comfortable, then you're just going to naturally go into flexion. That position in flexion when you're reaching things, when you're throwing a ball, all of that is going to compromise your shoulder, it's going to compromise your neck, it's going to compromise your back, and that's where pain starts. I've done several blogs, you know, that mention shoulder pain and posture, Dowager's hump and posture. So, you know, if you want more information, just check on those. But mostly what I want you to get from this blog is that it's so very important that you find mindful moments of movement in your day. And so when you're coming out of doing, you know, a transition in your life, so you wake up, and if you're a side sleeper, then make sure that you be like your cat and you stretch and you just extend your limbs laying flat on your back. If you, you know, just came out of a Zoom call, and even on Zoom calls, we tend to be attentive to the person in front of us. So just take a moment and extend your body. So just these momentary position changes is so very wonderful and so very important to keep you pain-free. Another so important thing is when we are actually making time to exercise. We make time to exercise to do the things we love to do, whether it's gardening or whether it's sports. And when we do sports, you know, if you think about how someone goes to throw a ball, well, that beautiful rotation that happens through the body doesn't happen very well when we're in flexion. We don't get enough rotation. Rotation is opened up by the movement of the spine in extension. And so you want to ensure that you get that motion pattern anytime you're going to go to the gym. You don't want to go to the gym and keep doing what you're doing all day, which is all forward movement, but rather focus on really opening through the body, making the resistance be for the back body and not so much for the front body. A lot of people don't realize that when they spend time in flexion, the muscles in the front of the body, mainly your pectoralis muscles, and the muscles that attach to the front of the arms, your latissimus dorsi, these muscles get tight. And when they get tight, they start to limit your extension. The other thing that's happening is that the muscles of your back, especially of your upper back and neck, they are being stretched all day. So when they're being stretched, any muscle that's under a prolonged stretch is going to be weaker. So then when you try to sit up tall and stand tall, you're like, whew, feels like it takes a lot of work. It takes a lot of work because you've been in flexion for a long time. So again, going back to these mindful moments of movement where you maybe extend that to going, I'm just going to sit upright just a little bit longer. And so that your body starts to get more accustomed to being held in a more neutral position so that you could not just look your best, but be your best in terms of voice projection, in terms of functional movements of all of your body parts, as well as keeping your organs happy and your spine happy and your discs happy. A lot of individuals in their 30s and 40s and 50s have disc herniations, and this is because we spend too much time in flexion. A lot of people, as they get older and their bones get weaker, which is called osteoporosis, they spend too much time in flexion, and that causes wedge fractures or compressions at the front of the vertebral bodies. And so bringing yourself back to neutral as much as possible, finding that sweet spot between flexion and extension of your spine so that you can keep your spine happy and healthy your whole life through. I'm Margaret at Miller Guide. Have a lovely day.